Once again, good day everyone. Long, long ago, I lived by the beautiful river Sabarmati in Ahmedabad, Gujarat, where the Nehru Bridge was built by my father, Peter X. Rego, late Peter X. Rego. Ahmedabad Electricity Company, the earlier one, the older stations were built by him, and he was the first Indian to get into the post of the project engineer. The company was a British company, and those days there was lots of discrimination. For an Indian to reach that stage was impossible. He made it. His son Albert Joseph Rego also made a name there in Ahmedabad Electricity Company. I started on the rung of the lowest level of a ladder, but I raised to be someone in life. But my foundation was put in there, Ahmedabad Electricity Company. We have memories. I grew up there for some time. Gujarat is a beautiful place, so are the Gujaratis. I made lots of friends. I can still sing some Gujarati songs, and particularly during the Garba, that is Navratri, I can still sing Kammamara Nandajina Lal Murli Kare Vagade. That's a beautiful one. And do that. Nowadays they call it Dandiya, but those days they were calling it was not Dandiya, it was known as Navratri celebration. My brother was also involved in it because he was All India Radio singer and harmonica player. Netravati River is a beautiful river, and there was a ship by her name, passenger ship, sailing from Cochin to Karachi. Then there was another river, Sonavati. That Sonavati, Sona has disappeared, Vati has disappeared. Now it is all Mati. Means our people are so smart, they have dried it up. There was again another ship known as Saraswati. That Saraswati ship was captured by the Pakistanis during 1965 war. It is never returned to India again. However, that river also has dried up. Then we have river Netravati. Netravati is a beautiful river. And particularly the place where I'm sitting right now, it is known as Lobos River View. I come here once in a while whenever I'm mentally bit depressed or mentally out of tune. I come here for relaxation, and that is where I get inspiration to write the poetries, the proverbs, hundreds of proverbs which I've written. I get all that feeling here. Many a times you see a couple of peacocks and peahens flying around here, and so are the ducks and ducklings. It's a pleasure to be around, and particularly if you want to relax, you be their guest. They will entertain you. Mr. Ian Lobo, son of Mr. F.M. Lobo. F.M. Lobo is a very close friend to me, and Ian Lobo is like a son to me. Then, after meeting all these people, I met someone very special. And that someone special happened to be a friend named Revati. From Sabarmati to Sonavati, from Sonavati to Saraswati, from Saraswati to River Netravati, and in the end, I landed with Revati. A wonderful human being, a loving person, and caring too. Always smiling, always laughing. That's the most beautiful gift a human could ever possess. A laughter does not come. It is not only outward, it comes from within. Shuddha Atma Paramatma. When the Atma is Shuddha, when the soul is clean, the smile comes. And when the smile comes, it radiates. And it radiates. And it radiates. It goes on radiating. Just like the sun. When the sun rises with only one spot. And slowly, you watch the sunrise. And slowly that spot, bright, it goes on brightening and brightening. And then the rays, they embrace the earth and the universe. The same way, I found a good friend for whom I care. And she is not Netravati, but Revati. Hats off to you, sweetheart, wherever you are, whether you're listening or not. Be happy with it. You deserve that very much. And always keep smiling, because a smile can change. Two enemies can unite through the smile. The distance of a smile is measured not in inches, not in centimeters, not in kilometers, but in mile. If you smile at the end of the day, you will pass a mile to meet a smile. Smile is such a beautiful thing. It's such a powerful media. Nobody can steal it away from you. It is your special gift given by God to you, if you believe in God. And from that smile comes a laughter. And when you laugh, the entire world laughs with you. But if you're crying, it is only but you and you alone. So you can't wear a gooey face and walk around and say, people don't like me. They like you. It's your mistake to think that they don't like you. They like you. But they certainly don't like your gooey face. And nobody likes it, not me. Many times I ask people, have you ever seen a horse laughing? They will ask me, why you say that? Because there are only two beings. One is a horse, never laughs, and the other one is the person whom I met just now. With that, we will conclude for today. Shall we smile again? And to all the lovely people of the world, let me wish each and everyone a happy day ahead.